Jim and Chelsea on New Country 103.1.
Text the word "been there," and yeah, it's one word, "been there." 855-400-9475 if you can relate to the following scenario. So if you experience this, one word, type it, "been there." You get out of bed. You're ready for the morning, right? You're doing your morning ritual. You do the shao shao and everything like that. You do
I'm sorry. You do the what?
The shao shao.
What is that?
It's a little shower. A little shower. You do the shao shao. You know, brush your teeth, do your hair, and you're getting dressed, and you're like, oh, all right. I remember last night I popped the load of clothes into the dryer. I got to go get my jeans. And so you're skipping down the hall. You're feeling good. Like, I'm ready for this day. I'm going to go in. I'm going to see Chelsea. She's always has a smile first thing in the morning.
Yes, like, I do.
Like that.
Yeah, a big one. Sorry.
Her daughter hasn't been up since 2.
Oh, God.
You reach into the dryer, and you grab those jeans, and they are still wet from the night before.
That's the worst. That is the absolute worst.
And you think to yourself, crap.
I have a lot of questions, actually.
And all of a sudden, because you have no choice. You have no choice. All of your pants were in that load.
I'm like, do you only have one pair of jeans?
No, I have several pair of jeans, but last night I decided to go for broke and do all of them at once.
Oh, that was brilliant.
Yeah, that was a bad, bad thing.
So, are you sitting in wet jeans right now?
I'm glad you asked me that, my co-host.
Ew.
And you put that first leg... You put that first leg into that cold, damp cave.
You couldn't even give yourself like a 10-minute air fluff? I can wait.
No.
You don't have to get here so early.
There was no fluffing available.
There was no... You couldn't do an extra 10-minute little...
No, these were... We're going to need a run through again.
So you decided to instead just put them on?
And as you're putting on the second...
You couldn't grab a pair of shorts?
As you're putting on the second... No, you don't want to. No, the shorts are unavailable on this one. And as you're putting that second leg through your cold, wet, damp jeans, you're mathematically figuring out at what point are they actually going to be dry? And you figure...
Never.
About an hour.
No.
About an hour or so.
No, when you go home and put them back in the dryer, they hold.
Oh.
They hold moisture real well.
Maybe you're in your truck, because apparently you all own trucks. And to help dry them, you think it's a great idea to turn all the vents onto your legs and turn the heater on. And that doesn't do anything. It doesn't dry your jeans. It just makes you sweat profusely in your car.
Wow. You've created quite the image for me here this morning. So now you're wearing wet, cold, sweaty jeans.
Yeah.
Maybe you should change. Maybe take a personal day. I gotta be honest.
So, if you've ever pulled out damp jeans from the dryer and you were wearing them anyway,
855-400-9475,
just text the word "been there." They're about a 7.
Ew.
They were very...
Oh, you know what?
Very cold, very damp.
I have a blow dryer.
Really?
You want to blow those bad boys?
Yeah, get it out right now.
I can do that.
All right. So, here...
I got you.
Because, I mean... It's,
all those days you make fun of me having a blow dryer in here. Well, looky, who needs me now?
The worst part is around the seams.
I don't want to hear where the worst parts are. I really don't want to know.
Let me tell you the coldest, darkest place.
I don't. Go to your cold, dark place. It's Tim's jeans. It's the crotch of Tim's jeans. I don't need to go there. Nobody needs to go there. We're all good. Yeah.
It's a cold and frigid, lonely place.
I got it. Yes, I will take, for 200, what is Tim's jeans?
So if you have ever pulled those damp jeans out of the dryer and you've had to wear them, just type the one word, "been there." 855-400-9475. What an unbelievable game yesterday, U.S. men's soccer versus Iran.
Oh, good.
Unreal.
Good.
Top three things is coming up next. Hold on. This is really a powerful
little
thing,
isn't it? You make fun of me for having a blow dryer in here. Look who needs me now in my amazing blow dryer.
My legs are getting all warm now.
That's great. Okay, too much information for me. Thank you.
Top three things you need to know coming up next with Tim and Chelsea. It's New Country 103.1.
I've always been a rolling stone.
Three things you need to know to start your day with Tim and Chelsea.
Hollywood will seriously reboot any movie ever made.
I feel like it's like, oh, we got to the end of the Rolodex. Let's go back to the beginning.
Oh, the movie they're about to remake, this is the worst call in history. We'll tell you about that coming up here in just a second. Welcome to Wednesday. Top three things you need to know. First and foremost, the U.S. men's soccer team moving on in the World Cup.
To McKay, Des making a big run. It's been for him. Des is stuck in behind. Des in the middle. Pulisic scores!
Wow. That game was unbelievable.
It was such a good game.
I mean, seriously, I had heart palpitations in the last 5 minutes.
Well, yeah, because then it's like Iran scored in the last second, but then they didn't, and I was like, oh, my God!
It was.
And then the U.S. goal that I thought went in, but then the guy was offsides, the second goal. Oh, my God.
Pulisic, by the way, who went to the hospital, got treated and all that sort of stuff, he said he's going to be ready for their game against the Netherlands.
Yeah.
So he will be back. But
that was awesome.
Holy crap. That last, 2 minutes was where they just kept clearing the ball. And then Iran would just put it back. Wow.
It was unbelievable. Did you see yesterday during the game, there was a guy in the stands they showed, and he was holding a sign that he was from Melbourne, Florida?
Yes, I did see him.
I was trying to get my phone out to be like, oh my God, there's a guy from Melbourne.
I actually said, oh wow, that just happened with Chelsea. And I was going to take a picture, and then I looked at my phone's way over there.
Don't hurt yourself. We don't want you to pull something while watching.
Like out of arm's length
the professional
right there.
Soccer players.
The U.S. men's soccer team, their next opponent is Netherlands. Is it Friday or Saturday, the game?
No, I got to look.
Wow. Absolutely amazing.
So good.
Now, McDonald's.
Saturday at 10.
McDonald's is doing this, the McGold card.
If you like McDonald's, a chance to win it free for the rest of your life, maybe most of the rest of your life. One award winner will be awarded a rare card in mobile form, entitling them to free McDonald's for the next 50 years.
I mean, let's face it.
What?
You have free McDonald's, you ain't living 50 years.
That's horrible. Anywho, let's see. So they're giving away 12 McGold cards, which grant you free McDonald's for life. You have to participate in their season of sharing promotion, which involves ordering through their app. Technically, there's a limit on the McGold card. It only covers 2 free meals per week for 50 years.
Oh, all right.
Which you would think would be plenty.
I'm back in the game then.
I have a friend who eats there every day. It's not going to be enough for her. Yeah. No.
Well, no, seriously. Two meals a week, I'm good to go. You give me free, you give me a blank check at McDonald's, I'm going down after day 2. There ain't enough quarter pounders that you can keep on hand.
Oh my God.
Yum, 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 yum. What? Don't you love, all right, what's your favorite thing at McDonald's?
2 cheeseburger meal.
That's the same thing as a quarter pounder.
No, it's not even close.
Yes,
it's 2 individual little cheeseburgers.
If you put the cheeseburgers together, it's a quarter pounder.
Different bun. Oh, my God. The people at McDonald's are hating you right now. Shut up, Larry.
If you add it all together, it's the same equivalent.
No, doesn't have lettuce. It's a totally different taste of a sandwich. You're a ding-dong. Good night. Go home. You're drunk. Put your pants in the dryer.
I'm way off on that call.
Go home, put your pants in the dryer. Not even close.
All right. They will reboot anything in Hollywood, and there are just some movies that should not be remade, yet Hollywood will say, what the heck? Let's do it anyway. And yes, Hollywood has announced they are rebooting Easy Rider from 1969.
I have to be honest, I never saw this movie. I wasn't alive either, in my defense.
In 1969, they made this movie called Easy Rider. Peter Fonda and Jack Nicholson, Dennis Hopper.
I mean, those are a lot of stars.
Huge. It was a cult following film based off of these guys who went from somewhere in Arizona to Louisiana based off the profits of a drug deal. That's what it is.
God, I love the good profit of a drug deal.
So.
Makes me want to just go get on my bike.
So they're like, why not reboot that? Because it's so relatable these days. Well, this is what the producers say. They're making it, remaking it, so they can give the youth of today a film that pays serious attention to their own countercultures and challenges. Right? So, they're going to be making Easy Rider. So it's not a bunch of hippies in the 70s on a drug trip. It's it's a bunch of 20-somethings with man buns, skinny jeans. They're not on Harleys, they're on Vespas. and they're rolling down the highway.
Let's ride.
Well, you're really selling me on this writing, let me tell you.
Well, it's the countercultures and challenges of today.
Uh-huh.
They don't stop off at bars, they stop off at Starbucks.
I just need to be alone with my thoughts. I just need a minute. The bike has been so loud. Your bike is loud as mine.
Did you get your Frappuccino? All right, everybody on their Vespas. Let's ride.
I'm good here.
0 to 60. Well, no, 0 to 30.
0 to 25.
0 to 25 in a week and a half.
School zone.
Jim and Chelsea on New Country 103.1.
Let's ride.
Oh, God, no, thank you. Unless they make it like a Fast the Furious, and it's like...
No, there won't.
Okay, then, okay.
Get your man buns tight. Here we go.
All right. Ladies, what happens when your husband calls you a cougar?
We'll
ask Chelsea what happened.
Oh, so much weird conversation.
Because that was a conversation in her house last night. It's coming up at 6:30 with Tim and Chelsea.
New Country 103.1 and Demesmond and Dover present the return of South Florida's most delicious country music festival, Rib Roundup. Saturday, March 4th at the I Think Financial Amphitheater. The best barbecue joints in South Florida. Mixed with live music on three stages for a full day of fun. Russell Dickerson will be there. So will CMA New Artist and Female Vocalist of the Year, Lainey Wilson. And Joe Nichols. Corey Kent. Two next from Nashville Guitar Pools. And another wave of artists to be announced soon. Tickets are on sale now. Get yours soon before the price increases kick in. Rib Roundup 2023. Presented by Demesmond and Dover, your accident attorneys. And South Florida's New Country 103.1. New Country 103.1 traffic. Presented by Rubenstein Law. 1-800-FL-LEGAL.
While gas prices are still high, the cost of taking a Brightline train is coming down. With fares now starting at $10 when you book at least 2 days before you ride. Dump the pump, book today at GoBrightline.com. Did have a vehicle fire now extinguished in Jupiter. It's on Indian Town Road east of the Beeline Highway. No other major accidents reported in the area, but there are fire rescue crews on the scene. Traffic is a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi in the 850 WFTL Traffic Center. I'm Karen Curtis.
The brand new Palm Beach Mitsubishi is the local leader in customer service.
eBay Motors, let's ride.
All of their poor life decisions led them to each other. Use this show as a cautionary tale. Stay in school, make better choices, or you could turn out to be like Tim and Chelsea. On New Country 103.1.